أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. Indeed, all praise to Allah today. We praise Him, we ask for His help, and we pray against the difference. And we seek refuge and protection in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the evil of ourselves and from the evil passages of our sins. Therefore, Allah has our lives on a straight path, no force in the universe can withstand Him. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, no one can guide His people. Let bear witness that there is no God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the one who stayed with Him and sent Him His peace in the name of Him. Today, the text of Scripture is a brief message that I want to share with you. I want to talk about self-examination, not only on a personal level, but also on a community level as Muslims in the United States. The Rasulullah Ta'ala has urged us several times at the Quran to engage in this self-reflection and this self-examination. We take the right to consider the teacher, the ayah in truth, the Rasulullah Ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لَغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ This can be translated as, O you who believe, fear Allah and seek your counsel. And let every person look what he has set forth for tomorrow. And fear Allah, very well from Jaya, is all that the world is going to do. This verse is a proof that it's made in the introduction of the examination of ourselves. And also, we need to examine ourselves before we are called into itself to be examined from the world of Jesus. That's a part of our religious spirit to hear from this verse. In addition, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by this self-reflection, self-examination. We can look to see the Qiyamah in the first two ayahs. The Rasulullah Ta'ala says, La yuhsinu yawmul qiyamah, wa la yuhsinu nafsun lawwamah. This can be translated as, I swear by the day of resurrection, I believe in, and I swear by the self-reflection person, I believe in. What is this is? This self-reflection, Allah SWT swears on it, and it's important. This is how we go about this act of there are many ways to say God's talk about that too. The first is in reference to his eyes is remembering the day of the judgment. In remembering the day of the judgment, remembering the day of the Lord who resurrected him, we allow ourselves to always return back to our true intelligence and to engage on the self-reflection. And so to end that, I think second, and also comes out of the faith. When I die, I'm going to use that, I'm going to just say, no, I'm going to 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 say, well, God, and it's God, and I bet you really saw your day, I told you that I do have, what if I do, what if I do have for you, what if I do not have for you. And you shall set a balance of justice on the day of resurrection. Then none will be dealt with unjustly in the kingdom. And if there may be a weight of injustice to you, you will bring it, as sufficient we are to take that fight. If you want to remember that we will be called upon for our actions, you remember to go back and reflect and consider that life. Our value and our needs for doing are all in line with what we want to do and resolve to be. Because at the end of the day, it's a marathon and where we end up matters more than what's going to be. In addition, I want to talk to our successful other examples to illustrate how we can do this. It's look at some times, 8-10 off those artists, when next year, one mass on the right, and you come up with you, one child up with your right, but the next night, I'm not going to have some good at all, but for the father, I'm not going to get sad. And he told it as when he met, and him who perfected him in the prison, and he told him what is wrong and what is right for him. And he is the truth, he purifies himself, and follows the faith of the Son of God. And indeed, he fills the corrupt future. Right? So, in summary, I want to point to the fact that if we engage in self-reflection, and we do it early, we allow ourselves to purify and restore life and to give it to others. The second way that we can do through it is examine ourselves and engage in self-introspection and dialogue is to remember our most important thing. And it's like, I feel like I have this, it's more like a thought in I-7. But once upon a time, I said something very, very interesting. Once upon a time, I said, what you get to tell me is that you remember the guy who is still alive. And really, because I want to examine this guy and really look at the intricacies of what was upon a time for you. The translation is, if you speak aloud, then you do feel what's upon a time. Know the secrets of what is even more good. So there's something interesting about this guy, right? And once upon a time, I mentioned the secret, which is something that you think, that we all keep, but others don't know. But he also mentions, in addition to that, what is hidden. Right? And it seems kind of odd because the secret is hidden, so why is this extra aspect of what is hidden? And the interesting thing about this prayer is that the hidden parts of what is called what he refers to would be things that we don't even know are secrets to ourselves. Things that we don't necessarily have knowledge about our own behaviors that we may not be aware of. Right? So what's my thought is going to the fact that your team, Noah's father, he will reveal to us those things that you don't even know about yourself. Those part of our interactions that we keep in our sight and we don't even know how to manifest themselves in a good way. In addition, what's my father talks about is the fact that if you get to know him, you can indeed get to know more about yourself. And see the person I didn't know see what's my father says. The life of who we can go here is in the world. The enemy saw him and for something. We now have to get him in the first place. The second thing is, it's not only among those who forgot what was the first time. And so, as a result, they are also starting to forget themselves and even people who are in the world. And it's just going to go over to this is that the people who forgot what was the first time, the rest of the time, are going to forget themselves. The opposite of that is the people who get to know what's going on, allowing them to pass along and to know themselves and make it and make it to you. So, the message here is that you can do those people to first learn and understand the addressing and what the truth is, but also allow them to know what's going on. The parallel is probably what the same people can do with the truth. If we were to have a self-aware of the truth, and we see the same So the first example I want to focus on introspection on an individual level. But the second month, I want to read this first question about this introspection of the U.S. community. I think one thing that's very interesting about what some of us missing in this country is that Muslims have a very rich and deep history in this country. And understanding ourselves that helps inform how we move forward. As a community, we can find our own history in this country that helps us as a community to move forward. So I just want to highlight some very interesting points of the Islamic history in the United States. We know from history, for example, that Thomas Jefferson owned a personal property of the land. We also know that when Jefferson in 1805 welcomed the ambassador from Tunis, the ambassador was Muslim and due to his fasting during the Ramadan, Jefferson actually delayed his dinner. It used to be at 3:50 and he delayed to have his sunset in order to have a first supply to Muslim. Right? These are things that are in our history as the United States that relate to Islam. In addition, we know that Islam was a rich history. Starting even before the independence, but also in the slave holocaust, the preserved essence, 10% of the slaves who entered the states were Muslims. And we have autobiographies of these Muslims, early Muslims who were enslaved and brought to the country in the life of Umar ibn Sa'id, who lived from 1770 to 1854, who was captured from Senegal, and he was a very prominent trader at the time. And in his writings, he talks about Islam and his journey. Through Islam and with slavery in his autobiography. One of his centers are some of the early examples of Islam in the country. We also have examples from the famous Moorish king by the name of Moorish prince by the name of Abdul Rahman Rahim, who was brought into slavery and many people advocated for his release as he had a president of the country. So we know that in the United States, there is a history of Islam for very, very long. If you understand this history, it's going to give us reference to us to go out and study from home to understand that Islam is taken as a life history. I've heard a lot of times all of this sort of people who engage in it in the discussion, not only on the personal level, but among all the community level, and that's what we're going to get into the next few days. Rabbana, la tu'akhidhna in nafsina khata'atan. Rabbana, wa la tahmil 'alayna isran kama tahmilu 'ala alladhina min qablina. Rabbana, wa la tahmilna 'ala ma la taqata lana bih. Was the favorite favorite. It's a 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 fav